We look at things in context in almost every field, except perhaps the Bible. For example, if somebody said sunny, you think, is it the sunny Leone the newspapers often talk about? Is it Sunny Gavaskar, the legendary Indian batting hero, Indian opener, former opener? Or is it sunny the weather? Or is it sunny the car which the Nissan company has rolled out? So we want to know which sunny. We want to see the things in context. Or if you heard the news that Netherlands beat India, you want to ask the question, in which sport? If Netherlands beat India in hockey, that's not a big news. If Netherlands beat India in cricket, India are giants of the game. Netherlands are perhaps just starting out. That's a big shock. So we naturally see things in context. But I'm amazed how many preachers of God's word take Bible verses out of context to promote poisonous, hell-taking, false teaching. That is, and one of which is hypergrace. For example, we can read 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 21, where it says, He made the one who did not know sin to be sin for us, so that we become the righteousness of God in Him. So they point to this verse and say, we are the righteousness of God, as if we can do anything because we are the righteousness of God. We can live in sin, we can watch porn, we can lose our temper, you know, we can do whatever we want because we are the righteousness of God. It is true we are the righteousness of God. But the very next verse, when we read the Bible in context, the very next verse talks about our responsibility because we are the righteousness of God. The very next verse, in fact, is the next chapter. Chapter divisions were not part of the original Bible. We know that. And the next verse is 2 Corinthians 6:1. It says, working together with Him, we appeal to you, don't receive God's grace in vain. Don't receive God's grace in vain. We use the grace of God to live a holy life. We don't receive God's grace in vain. And the 7th chapter verse 1 makes it even more clearer. When we read the whole, when we look at the context of the whole book, it says 7th chapter verse 1, 2 Corinthians. Therefore, dear friends, since we have such promises, let us cleanse ourselves from every impurity of the flesh and spirit, completing our sanctification in the fear of the Lord. The fact that we are the righteousness of God should not remove the healthy fear of God from our life. 2 Corinthians 7:1 says, in the fear of God, completing our sanctification and cleansing ourselves from every impurity in our life. We must continue to live a holy life enabled by the grace of God. God, help us to read the Bible in context and escape false teachings like hypergrace. God bless you.